it's time for Timothy. Yes, it's time for that little mouse with a big message and all his wacky and wonderful friends. So come a-runnin' and enjoy the fun with Timothy's adventure of the Sea Scrapers.
I'll show them a thing or two. Will they ever be sorry when they find out I'm gone? Gone for good. I'll never come back home. No, sir. I'll just camp right here beside the pond. From now on, this'll be my home.
Quack, quack, quack.
Come on, Quacks, old buddy. Look here. Here's a swallow pond for you and me to swim in. Go ahead and try it out.
Quack, 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 quack.
Imagine they're saying that you're too big for the bathtub. And that you have to live outside in the pond now. No house ducks in the house, they said. Well, I'll show them a thing or two. If you can't live in my room anymore, then I won't live there either. I'd live right here in this pond with you.
Grow? Well, as I live and breathe, if it isn't Timothy. What are you doing out here so late in the day, Tim? Isn't it almost supper time at home?
Oh, hello, Grandfather Frog. I've just moved. I'm not living at home anymore. I'm living here.
Here? You mean right here? By the pond? I should think your own room would be much more comfortable.
Maybe so. But if my duck has to live here, then I'm going to live here too.
Oh, so that's it, is it? Well, now, a pond is a very fine place to live if you happen to be a duck or a frog like me. You see, Timothy, God made some of us to live in or around water, and for us, a pond really is a grand place to live. But others, like yourself, he made you live on dry land. A pond can be a pretty miserable place to stay if you're not a water animal. No, you need your people friends to talk to and play with, a dry bed to sleep in, and the other things you're used to. I'm afraid that a pond wouldn't make a very good home for you.
But I like to swim a lot. And living here, I could swim all day long and never come out. Well, except maybe at night. Then I could sleep right here on the bank, and it'd be just like camping out.
You know, Tim, you sound just like I did a few years back. Well, when I was a little young frog, a little more than a tadpole, really, I decided that I wanted more than anything to go to the big sea, or ocean as you know it, to seek my fortune.
Golly, Grandfather Frog, I never heard of a frog living in the ocean.
Well, exactly, Timothy. A small pond frog is as much at home in the big sea as well, as you would be there. You can imagine how well you'd fit into ocean life, Tim.
Golly, that'd be great. Off to the sea to seek my fortune. My fortune. My fortune. My fortune. Policeman, we're here in the big sea for the first time and, well, we're lost. Can you tell us which way we should go to seek our fortune?
Yes, indeed. You're looking for Fortune Street. That's a long way from here on the outskirts of the city. You have to go through some pretty rough sections of town to get there, up past Crocodile Bay and on through the Clam Chowder area. Why don't you catch a dolphin cab and let him take you there? Then you won't have to worry about any directions. Do be careful, though.
Yes, sir, we will. And thank you very much, sir. Gee, a dolphin cab. Wow! Oh, come on, Grandfather Frog. Let's go find one. Over here, Grandfather. Here's a real live dolphin cab over here. Come on, Grandfather Frog. Let me help you up. Thanks, Grandfather.
Take us to Fortune Street, Cabby.
Golly, Grandfather Frog, this place is really something. Just look at those skyscrapers. Maybe they call them seascrapers down here. Anyway, they sure are tall. Hey, look, over there. We're passing the zoo. Look at that! Some of their sea animals are a lot like the animals in our zoo back home. Look, there's a lionfish. And there's a leopard gannard. Wowie!
Yes, and there's an Atlantic wolffish. And why, look over there, Tim. A rainbow parrotfish and an eagle ray next to it.
I wish we had time to stop at the zoo, but I'm just too anxious to find out what's on Fortune Street.
Well, what do you know? Look over there, Tim. Lover's Lane.
Stupid fish. Oh, it's beautiful down here, Grandfather. I wonder why that policeman warned us to be careful.
I don't know, Tim. We may find out soon enough. I think we're on Crocodile Bay right now.
Crocodile Bay? That's kind of a nice-sounding name. Oh, look! There's a crocodile. And what a pleasant smile he has on his face. He seems friendly enough. Hello, Mr. Crocodile. A lovely place you have down here.
Why, thank you, friend Mouse. Come, I'll show you around and introduce you to our leader, King Crocodile. I know he'll want you to stay for dinner. He always has his guests for dinner.
Dinner? Well, okay.
Timothy, I think we'd better look out. I've heard a lot about these crocodiles. They're not always as friendly as they seem to be. Now, here's my advice to you.
But he's invited me to dinner. I'm going whether you are or not. Grandfather Frog, you were sure right about those crocodiles. They go around with big smiles on their faces, but those smiles don't mean a thing. Except maybe how happy they'd have us for dinner. Their dinner, that is.
Boy, that was a narrow escape, Tim. I'm glad we're out of that bay. Say, speaking of dinner, I'm getting hungry. There's a restaurant up ahead. What say we stop in and have something to eat?
Boy, that's a swell idea. Bet you I could eat a horse.
Yes, sir. May I suggest our blue plate special for today? Horse roast served in seaweed gravy.
Horse roast? I said I could eat a horse, but I didn't mean it.
Oh, but, sir, our seahorses are the very best.
Oh, seahorses. Oh, seahorses.
Oh, yes, sir. Or maybe you'd prefer our famous jelly sandwich.
Oh, yes, ma'am. That's what I prefer, all right. Your famous jelly sandwich. might add a little peanut butter, just to make it a little more famous, you know.
Well, I'm sorry, sir, but I never heard of peanut butter.
Well, that's all right. Just a plain jelly sandwich will be fine.
One jellyfish sandwich on rye.
Jellyfish? Oh, no. Wait. I just changed my mind again. Why don't you order first, Grandfather Frog? I don't feel so good.
Oh, now let me see. Frogs, where I come from, always eat bugs. I don't see it on the menu, but would you by any chance have any bugs, too?
Oh, I'm sorry, sir, but what is a bug?
Oh. Well, it's a... Well, never mind. Here's something that sounds good. Lobster. How about that, Tim?
Well, I'm not too much for seafood, really. But since there doesn't seem to be anything else, I guess that'll be okay.
One lobster coming up, sir.
Gee, I wish my folks would hear. They never had any trouble knowing what I'd like to eat. In fact, I like about everything they ever fixed for me.
Yes, I imagine then they'll miss not having a little church mouse to cook for anymore.
Of course, they still got Kathleen. But even then, I guess maybe they'll miss me. Boy, I miss them already. I even miss Kathleen.
Here comes our order, Tim. Gee, that was fast. I guess they must have already had it cooked.
That sure is a big dish. And look at the size of that lid.
Go ahead and take the lid off, Tim.
Oh, no! It's not cooked. It's not even dead yet. Help! Help! It's after me, Grandfather Frog. Oh, help! Let's get out of here fast. Boy, I'd rather go hungry than to go into another restaurant down here.
You know, somehow my appetite has left me, too.
Look out! What is that, anyway? Oh, help! It's after me!
Oh, that's just a catfish, Timothy. It's trying to be friendly, I think.
Go be friendly somewhere else, Kitty. I guess I'm not just in a friendly mood right now. Well, shoo, scat! Luckily, that dogfish came along then. But I sure hope he doesn't come back. He didn't look any more appealing to me than that catfish, friendly or not.
Say, we must be getting pretty close to Fortune Street. The policeman said it was just past the clam chowder area, and I think that's it just ahead.
Yeah, look at all those clams just sneaking around. I hear they're pretty rough characters, except when the policeman's nearby. A close one. It's a good thing those clams always clam up when they see a policeman. You know, I'm not so sure that I like it down here after all. It's just too dangerous.
Oh, I'm beginning to agree with you, Timothy. Besides that, it's downright uncomfortable. This salt water makes my eyes sting.
Yeah, mine too. But we've got to go on if we want to find out what's on Fortune Street. Maybe it's a pirate sunken treasure, or the pot of gold that's the end of the rainbow. Wouldn't that be great-grandfather? Why, we'd be rich as kings.
Of course, Timothy, it might not be money at all. You know, there are treasures richer than gold.
Treasures richer than gold? Well, what could they be? Oh, I guess you mean like diamonds and rubies and stuff like that, huh?
Well, that's not exactly what I meant, Tim. But let's just wait and see. Uh-oh. Look ahead there. A shark and a swordfish not far behind it. Look out, Timothy. Hang on for your life. Was really close. Dolphins certainly are good shark fighters. Thank you, Cammy. You did a great job, Tim. Where'd you ever learn to sword fight like that?
Oh, from Reverend Good. He gave me some lessons. I guess fencing was one of his favorite sports when he was in college, so he gave me some pointers.
Well, in fencing, I guess it's the pointers that count.
Oh, Grandfather Frog.
So it was Reverend Good who took the time to teach you fencing, I guess he really thinks a lot of you, Tim. He will probably miss you quite a lot, not having you around anymore.
Yes, I guess maybe he will. We did have quite a few good times together. And I sort of miss him, too. You know, Grandfather, this big sea is not the place for me. I don't belong here at all. Oh, how can we ever get back home anyway?
Wrong. Oh, I was just wondering the very same thing, Timothy. Right now, I'd like nothing better than to be back in my old home pond, far, far away from this big sea life. I hate to admit it, but I don't know the way back either. I guess the only thing to do is to go on to Fortune Street and see what's there. Right now, though, I can't imagine any fortune good enough to help us out of this situation. But look, there's a sign that says Fortune Street. Well, at last. I was beginning to think we'd never get there.
Look, Grandfather Frog. Do you see what I see guarding the entrance to Fortune Street? It's a great big octopus.
Say, Timothy, look, the octopus has a little sign in each hand. I wonder what they're for.
You must be the visitors here on Fortune Street. Your look so frightened. Really, there's no need to be afraid of me. You see, I'm the fortune machine here on Fortune Street. Each of my hands is a little sign that tells who should pick a fortune from that hand. You may come up to pick a card from the hand marked with your kind on it.
I don't suppose they'll even have a hand for me. I don't suppose there are very many mice that ever come down here.
Wait, Timothy. I found a hand marked frogs. And here's one marked church mice. You're in luck, Timothy. You're in luck.
Church mice? Wow! But what good will a little old fortune card do me anyway? I've gotten them before from the weight scales at Mr. Peavy's drugstore, and they never mean a thing. Shucks.
Well, let's take a look anyway. Oh, my. It's written in octopi. I can't read it.
I'll translate. The sea is not the place for you. No bugs to eat, nor insects stew. Salt butter serves to sting your eyes. Makes you itch as your skin dries. Fortune's yours when you do not roam. Take this advice. Pond frog, go home.
That sounds like good advice, all right. And now read mine.
Your real fortune lies in your home. Forsake it, and you are alone. Friends are fortune beyond measure. Don't trade them for other treasure.
Boy, that's true, all right. I wish I'd never run away from home.
No, there's more on the other side. A mouse cannot live in the sea. A fish mouse you will never be. Your fortune lies in your own hand to get back fast to your homeland. Hate to tell you, but I ordered. Mice cannot breathe underwater.
Oh, my gosh! That's right! Oh, help! 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 I can't breathe underwater!
Wake up, Tim. Wake up! You're dreaming, Tim. Wake up!
I'm rescued! Hey, boy! No, sir. The Big Sea is a nice place to visit, but I wouldn't want to live there. I'm going home. The octopus card said that was my real fortune, and it was right. God gave me my real fortune a long time ago, and I just didn't have enough sense to know it.
Well, Tim, I don't quite know what you're talking about when you mention your being in the sea and octopus cards and all that. But I do know what you mean when you say that it was God who gave you your fortune. Our real fortune is all around us. Our families, our homes, our friends, even the air we breathe, and the earth that gives us our food, our seas and waterways. All these things are our good fortune, our gifts from God. God loves us, Timothy. And if we try to follow his teachings by being kind one to another and by appreciating other people and all of God's many other gifts, well, then we can't help but have good fortune. Good fortune all around us, everywhere.
You're right, Grandfather Frog. I'm going home. But what about good old Quacks here? I sure do hate to leave him.
Well, of course you do, Timothy. But this pond isn't far from your house. You can come to visit him every day.
And you think he'll really be better off here than he was living in my room?
Oh, yes, indeedy. You see, God gave ducks some special gifts, too. He made them so that they could fit into pond life very well. Look at his feet, for instance. God made them webbed so that he can travel easily in water. Even his feathers are special. They're covered with an oil that makes them waterproof. They keep him afloat and insulate him against the cold. He'll enjoy swimming here even in the coldest weather, Tib. And another thing about him that you've probably noticed is his wide bill. It isn't at all like a chicken's pointed beak. No, siree. God even made that bill in a very special way. It's flat and almost spoon-shaped so that he can catch bugs and other good food out of the water or mud. You see, Timothy, God took care of all his creatures by making them especially suited to their surroundings.
Oh, I think I'm starting to understand now. My wanting to keep my duck in my room all the time was really keeping him away from his natural surroundings. He doesn't belong there any more than I belong in the sea. I guess I was trying to keep him away from the good fortune God gave him. God made him so he'd be happiest in the pond, didn't he, Grandfather?
That's right, Timothy.
Well, goodbye, old friend.
Quack, quack, quack.
I'll be back to visit you tomorrow. Now you have the fortune that God gave you, and I'm going back to the fortune he gave me. I'm going home.
Time now to leave Timothy. But join us again next week for another exciting adventure with Timothy and his friends.